Hello again, everyone, from Tokyo, Japan, and welcome back to Japan Vintage Camera. I'm once again at Hinokicho Park, enjoying the beautiful day here. I decided to try to make as many videos as I can over the weekend, and I'll go ahead and upload them during the week. It's a very beautiful day here, and I want to take advantage of the nice weather. In Japan and Tokyo, I guess Japan in general, the springtime weather is very unpredictable here. It can be rainy and cold, sometimes snowy. Then it can be warm and clear. It can be very windy. It can be very still. The only thing which is consistent about springtime in Japan is that it is inconsistent. Yesterday it was quite cold and rainy here and very miserable, and not today to go outside, whereas today is an idyllic day. It's very warm, it's sunny, and quite a beautiful day to come out and enjoy the park and also to make a video. Anyway, the subject of today's video is going to be another Konica rangefinder camera, one of the later Konica rangefinder cameras. This one is the C35, which is a full-frame 35mm camera and one of the last of the classic rangefinder cameras which Konica produced. Konica produced a large variety of C35 cameras over a very long period of time. This is the original version of the C35, which is a very compact rangefinder camera, whereas the later ones were scale focus cameras. It features aluminum top and bottom covers, whereas the later versions featured plastic top and bottom covers. There was a similar camera which looks a lot like the classic C35, and it's called the C35 ENL, which is basically the same camera as this, but without the rangefinder mechanism. The C35 ENL does with a simple scale focus mechanism, and you can see the focus distance when you look through the viewfinder. The classic C35, this one here, allows for a little bit more, I guess, precision in focus because it features the rangefinder. Another C35 was the C35 FD, which was sold here in Japan and was similar in size to the ordinary C35, except that it featured a fully manual shutter, or the shutter allowed for manual operation, and it also had a faster f1.7 lens. Those cameras are a little bit harder to find here in Japan, especially in good working condition. And as much as I really like them, when I find a good working one, I tend to avoid those because they're not very reliable. They have kind of a semi-automatic operating system where you set the shutter speed and the camera sets the aperture, but the light meter in these cameras often doesn't work, and then though you can operate the camera halfway using the shutter, you can't really set the shutter, aperture, so I kind of avoid those. And whenever I try to find those here in order to resell, usually about half of them have faulty light meters, and so they're extremely difficult to try to fix, so I kind of avoid them altogether. The C35 continued production into the 70s and 80s, and it became kind of a black plastic consumer camera with a built-in flash. It featured the same lens, which is a 35mm f2.8 Hexenon lens, which is actually quite a good performer. And if you come across one of the later Konica C35s, the black plastic ones, it won't look quite as attractive as the earlier versions, but it will still take excellent photographs. A friend of mine had one of these cameras, and I think he still has it, and it is his favorite film camera. He's mainly a digital photographer, but he carries his old C35 as kind of a backup, or when he kind of feels the urge to shoot film. I'm always amazed at the kind of photos that he can capture with this, $20 later model Konica C35. So let's go ahead and take a look at the features, controls, and functions of the C35, starting at the top here. Quite a simple film rewind knob lever, however you want to call it. The lever pops out to give you a little bit of extra leverage if you're using, a 36 exposure roll of film and shooting on a cold day when the film gets a little stiff to rewind. Here we have a hot shoe for mounting a flash. You can use a modern strobe flash on the Konica C35. And when you're using a flash, you have to use the guide number system, using the guide numbers here on this ring on the base of the lens. Over on the right side here, we have the shutter release button, which accepts a standard cable release. And here we have the film winding and shutter charging lever. And to the right of that, we have the film counter window, which will, of course, goes up to 36 exposures. On the back here, we have the viewfinder window, which is a pretty good size. And if you wear eyeglasses, you'll be able to use this easily enough. This is a little bit bigger than what you find on some other rangefinder cameras of the day. On the front of the camera, we have the focusing ring. And we have a range here, which measures also in meters and feet. And on the front here, just like the last review I did of the Olympus 35 RC, we have a dial for adjusting the film speed. Over on this side here, we have a film, I guess, a self timer, which is quite a good function to have. And an interesting thing, normally I recommend people don't use the self timer on old vintage cameras, but the Konica C35 is the only rangefinder, or I guess vintage camera, I've come across where I've never had a problem with the self timer not working. Now, that's not to say that that they all work all the time. It's quite possible that you might come across one where the self timer doesn't work, but in my experience, it's quite a bit more reliable than the ones which came on the earlier Konica rangefinder cameras. On the bottom of here, we have a release button for unlocking the winding mechanism so you can rewind the film. Here we have a standard 3/8 inch tripod socket, and here we have the battery cover. And unlike other cameras of the time, the C35 uses a more commonly available LR or SR44 1.5 volt battery. So you don't really have to kind of hunt around to try to find a battery or battery adapter which will fit. Loading the camera is quite simple. You simply pull up on the rewind lever like so, and it pops open. And the C35 is another one of those cameras which uses a lot of this rubber foam for light seals, and something you have to be careful with. This camera I haven't really gone through yet. All I've done is pretty much tested the shutter and the light meter to make sure that they work. Later on this week, I'll go ahead and get into it and replace the light seals and all of that. When you're putting in the film here, simply push up on the forks here so you can drop your film cartridge inside. As usual, I hold down the film cartridge with my thumb and I pull the film leader across the opening here and feed it into the take-up spool. I'll go ahead and wind the film and fire the shutter until the film is all the way across and the holes on both sides of the film are engaged in the teeth here in this take-up sprocket. Then I will close the film door and wind it until the number one is showing in my film counter window, and I will be sure to set the film speed dial on the front of the lens to match the film which I have loaded in the camera. Now, the C35 is a very lightweight and compact camera. It's much more simple than other rangefinder cameras because the operation is automatic. Pretty much all you have to do with one of these cameras is load the film and wind the shutter and shoot. It will automatically select the best aperture and shutter speed for the available light. It also works quite well when you're using a flash. And as I said, we have the guide numbers located on the side here. And when operating the camera with the flash, you would simply just use the settings recommended on the flash, or for the, I guess, distance or range that you want to use. Quite simple. There's also a flash sync button on the side. I forgot to mention that if you are using some other kind of flash which won't work with the hot shoe on the front. So, overall, these are pretty good cameras, and I've sold a few of them over the years. As I said, they are a nice compact camera which you can carry in the coat pocket. Most of the cameras made came in this silver finish, which is kind of an anodized finish, kind of an anodized matte chrome over aluminum. A black version was also produced, and the black finish was also anodized. The C35 FD, the more expensive version, also came with the aluminum and top and bottom covers. You do have to be a little bit careful of these because as the metal or the material is aluminum, they are kind of easy to dent or scratch. This one fortunately doesn't have any dents, but there are a few scratches on it. There aren't really any weaknesses in these cameras compared to other rangefinder cameras which I come across. Most of these C35s which I come across, pretty much all I have to do is put in a battery, clean them up, replace the light seals, and they are ready to use. Whereas other cameras often require a lot of work to get them going. So quite a good camera and pretty well made. And if you happen to come across one of these and you want a good film camera, it's a really good choice. So anyway, that's about it for this video. I'll be posting this camera for sale in my online stores soon. So if you're interested in buying it, please visit one of my stores by clicking the links under the description in the video. I'll be posting more videos as I can. And if you like the video, please like it. If you want to see more videos, please subscribe. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you tune in again soon.